Good morning, Flagler Beach. Thank you for joining me today. I hope you've had a good week, and I hope you've got a good weekend planned in front of you. Just a quick reminder, this coming Saturday night, before you go to bed, turn your clock back 1 hour, because it's the end of daylight savings time. Here's a quick question for you. If you saw a friend or a neighbor that was in trouble, what would you do? Would you try to help them? Or would you simply shrug your shoulders and say, it's not my problem? I want to talk to you a little bit this morning about Nehemiah. Nehemiah lived in a very unusual time. He was still living in Persia and working for the Persian king, but the people of Judea had already been set free from their captivity and been sent back to Jerusalem. But when they got back to Jerusalem, they discovered it was a horrid mess. The temple had been torn down, the walls were torn down, and when some of them went back to Persia, they ran into Nehemiah, and he asked them about how things were going. Reading from Nehemiah chapter 1, "And they said to me, the remnant there in the province who survived the captivity are in great distress and reproach, and the wall of Jerusalem is broken down, its gates are burned with fire. Now it came about when I heard these words, I sat down and wept and mourned for days, and I was fasting and praying before the God of heaven." You know, Nehemiah could have just simply brushed them off and said, well, those boys down in Jerusalem, they better get their act together. But that's not what he did. He stopped what he was doing. He sat down, he wept, and he mourned, and he prayed. And he did this for days. He was asking God for guidance. What could he do to help his friends and his neighbors down in Jerusalem? When we find a neighbor or a friend in trouble, let's not just brush it off. Let's stop what we're doing. We might need to sit down with them. Sometimes we need to weep with them and mourn with them, and we might need to pray, okay, God, what can I do to help this person? Maybe they've got a problem at their job. Maybe they've got a problem in their family. Maybe they need some help with something. Ask God, what can you do to help out that family? It may be if they're looking for a job, you can act as a reference for them. Maybe if they've got a problem in their family, you can just kind of listen to them and help them figure out what they're going to do next. Or maybe you just need to sit there and be there with them and just simply comfort them. And just sometimes the presence of another person can make all the difference in the world. A sympathetic ear is more valuable than gold. Nehemiah chose to sit down, stop what he was doing, wept and mourned and prayed and asked God, what can I do? And everything that happens in the book of Nehemiah after that springs from that one single passage. He stopped, he sat down, he wept, he mourned, he prayed, and he did so for days, and God did amazing things. This week, when you see a family member or a friend or a neighbor that's hurting, don't just brush it off. Stop what you're doing, sit down, pray, ask God, what can I do to help my neighbor? Let's go to the Lord in prayer. Our most gracious Heavenly Father, Lord, we just ask you to help us to keep our eyes open, Father. Help us to be aware of those around us that are hurting, Father. Lord, help us to stop what we're doing, Father. Lord, help us to weep, to mourn, to pray, Father. Lord, help us to serve our neighbor, Father. Help us to love our neighbor and to put that love into action. Father, we love you. We praise you in Jesus' name. Amen. Well, thank you for joining me. I hope you have a blessed day and a blessed weekend.
Hey, I hope you enjoyed the devotional this morning. If you think somebody else might get a blessing out of it, feel free to share. If you're watching on YouTube, please subscribe. But at any rate, I hope you have a good day.